He's consistently been an outstanding researcher and educator. In fact, he's working on some state-of-the-art problems that are so complicated that it requires an exascale computer to solve them. In fact, there's only about 7 in the world that can do these types of calculations.
I see him as definitely a very knowledgeable resource for not just nuclear, but you know, numerical methods and modeling of all sorts of systems.
My goal is to try to find ways to exploit computers and computer software to solve complicated math problems involving the physics of radiation transport. Majority of my students end up going to the national laboratories to work. It's something I'm very proud of, that they develop practical skills and a deep understanding of both the physics and the math. They can write software and use software, and they can go in and be basically work ready fairly quickly.
If you look at nuclear power in the US and around the world really, what you find is that you have very large reactors, and we see that the cost has gone up and up. So developing a new class of nuclear power has been really key to moving the entire industry forward. Todd had done some research for us, which was a reactor physics analysis for our natural circulation core. And that led to one of our early patents, which was a stable startup system. And so that patent became one of the foundational pieces of IP that we used to spin out the company.
It's the only small modular reactor in the United States, actually anywhere in the world, I think, that's actually buildable. And it's nice to see those things actually be put in place to solve real problems that are of significance in the real world, not in academia.
You often get people in mechanical engineering working on nuclear-related problems and vice versa. He's really good about seeing how other people can contribute rather than wanting to be the person in charge or the person who's going to do everything or like bringing resources to himself. I think he's all about bringing others in and seeing how other people can contribute and sort of expanding teams.
You know, the perception that people have of nuclear engineers is that they're narrow, right? That they're deep and narrow in their understanding of systems because they only work in nuclear. But in fact, we're extremely flexible and broad and able to tackle all sorts of different problems. I'm a big sports fan. It's something that enriches my life, both physically, but also, so I'm not constantly thinking about work all the time. I'm proud of my kids. My 10-year-old and my 12-year-old are both playing youth league basketball, and we shoot around almost every night after work or after school. None of these things that we do happen it's not an individual sport, it's definitely a team sport. We're working in kind of a small program here at OSU, and to be recognized in this way is extremely humbling. It's interesting to think that people are looking and seeing what's happening with my research and my students, and it's a great community I'm part of in my little niche discipline, and I've been really fortunate to be part of it.